Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another presentation of FNM here at Nerd Rage Gaming. I'm your host, Andrew Donnelly. With me, now not guest co-host, but actual host of Nerd Rage Gaming Live, Matt Hausler. Matt, you're back, baby. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. I'm moving up.
You're moving on up in the world. This is official now.
The dream is real.
Yeah, you're the third official co-host of Nerd Rage Gaming Live.
Feels good to be number three.
Does it feel pretty good?
And that's my official statement.
Well, that's good. Well, look at this. We've got Barry Cohen and Alex Preisig, both Nerd Rage Gaming regulars, back in the booth here, ready to battle it out.
Gonna duel it out.
What do you think about this matchup here? Esper Control versus Jeskai Tokens.
Oh, boy. Well, Esper Control, it's Control. Not big on Control as a player myself, but
sure.
I respect it.
Okay.
You know? And we know Esper got some tools, kind of makes it a little more viable now. Just to name a few cards, I think we'll see some Gnar sets.
Okay.
Maybe some commands.
Sure.
I'm actually just more excited to see how it plays out. Because this matchup in general, game one, I think it's kind of a toss-up.
Okay.
It depends who gets, like, the better start. If Barry has, like, the cards to stabilize, or if Alex just has so much aggro action. We'll see how it plays out.
All right. Well, Alex leads off here with a Temple of Triumph. Looks like he scryed to the bottom with that one. Barry going to follow up with his Island and pass the turn. So I like this already. No turn one wacky creature play from the Esper Control deck.
Yeah, best card Magic Island, too.
I'm not going to complain. We'll see a fetch here from Alex. Most likely going to find either a Plains or an Island himself. Gets the Island. All three colors available to him now.
Yeah, blue gives him all three colors. Pretty important for the three-color decks.
Yeah, they're generally pretty skimpy on the amount of basic lands that they run.
Very true. Well, when you're in three-color land, the more dual lands, the tri-lands, the better.
Yeah.
We'll see if Alex can get going here.
This is a card he enjoys playing. That's a Dragon Fodder.
Juicy.
Decided to play that card. You like that card, huh?
I love Dragon Fodder.
Really? Okay. Interesting.
That card, right around the time I started playing.
Yeah.
You know, that was a thing.
That was.
You know, a little bit of my childhood.
That would have been...
wasn't a child, but, you know, you get me.
Should have been Shards Block, I believe, was Dragon Fodder.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you are correct.
I've played Magic once or twice.
Yeah, you know some things.
Occasionally.
Well, I'll give you credit.
Now, there's a salty draw for Alex in the form of Monastery Mentor.
Not a card you see very often. People kind of set that card by the wayside, just kind of this agreement that it didn't really have a home in Standard.
Yeah.
Very good in other formats.
Sure.
But, you know, Alex breaks all the rules.
That's
just
good.
Just doesn't care.
I'd do it, too. If I could play that card, make a board state, make some dudes. It's a white creature, though, so I'm probably not playing it. In reality.
It's a creature.
I'm probably not playing it. So there we see Anticipation. This will be at the end of Alex's turn. Barry fetched.
So he sees two lands and some gas.
That's a card I'm pretty fond of, actually. Anticipation was one of the few cards coming out of Dragon's Attack here that I actually liked.
Super good.
I think it's really solid and Standard.
Maybe the best uncommon out of the set?
Probably.
Yeah.
Easily. Well, maybe not easily, but pretty darn close. I mean, it definitely helped these guys who are looking to play a form of Control.
I think it enables any blue strategy in general, really.
Sure.
I think Alex could justifiably have some in his deck, but...
He's got one in his hand right now.
Oh, how about that?
So this is interesting. So now we run into the Control. As Barry is the Control deck here, you don't counter that Anticipate?
Isn't the general notion with Control is anything that gets them cards or enables their hand, you kind of just let go and mm-hmm. you wait for them to run out the good stuff before you counter it? So I think Barry has some justification to not just outright, like, counter this spell.
Counter that.
Let Alex get whatever he wants. I'll counter the good stuff, the stuff that's going to actually help him win the game or get some pressure out here.
And rightfully so. I think at this point, going into Alex's turn three, we know he's played Dragon Fodder so far. We know his follow-up plays could be Jeskai Ascendancy. They could be the Monastery Mentor. There's a lot of ifs going through Barry's head. What is he going to play with those cards that he's drawing?
Yeah, also a surprisingly slow start from Alex here. These two goblins are doing a considerable amount of work in that Barry has not answered them. They're not so bad that you need a response to them right away. But Alex is kind of getting the advantage of being able to leave cards behind.
Mm-hmm.
Should this game go to a game two or three and Alex doesn't have to run out that mentor or doesn't, you know, show that he has any other token generators, the better for Alex.
Sure.
sure. You know?
Interesting note, Barry just picked up his second source of black that came into play tapped, so able Alex being
no downfall,
able to play
around the, no bile blight.
Yeah, seems super good.
Yeah, these goblins doing a pretty good amount of work.
How do you feel about those Yeti goblins? You like those ones?
They're different.
They are different. The tiny Yeti goblins. I'm not a fan.
It's kind of like they're new, so sure.
So sure. they put hair on goblins. Why
I'm like
not?
I'm like a sucker for anything that's new. I just like instantly play it.
Sure.
Like the Theros lightning strikes. Okay. I just abandoned once they came out in M15 because ooh, they have a sweet new border.
Yeah. Yeah.
I gotta be consistent, so that's just how it goes.
Very
so
true.
I'd probably be playing with these newer Yeti goblins.
Okay.
Yeah,
so
that's
like
fair.
The Yeti goblins.
I guess you could say I like them. Yeah.
Yeah. Why not? So
why
there
not?
Is the spell that we thought Barry should counter.
And exactly. Yeah.
So.
Yeah. So whether Alex had that in hand or drew it off anticipate, we're actually just countering it. End result is the same.
The end result's the same in the fact that Barry now tapped down has to take 4 here from Alex's tokens.
The tokens are mountain.
Looks like we got a fan of Alex in the old chat here, kicking off the night. We've got Nicole.
Oh, okay.
Wow.
All right.
Welcome,
little,
Nicole.
Little cheering section for Alex.
There we go. Hey.
Dig it.
Everybody needs one.
I agree.
I don't have that many.
Me neither.
Okay.
And that's fine. You know,
Matt Dow actually probably has less than both of us.
Really?
I would
less
so.
Than zero?
Less than zero.
Mathematics disagree, but I'm going to just believe you because it's Matt Dow.
So here I think we're going to see one of my other favorite cards in Standard. That's a Treasure Cruise.
Yeah, that's a goodie. No counter up for that one.
No.
So again, though, if you're Barry, not necessarily needed to counter it. Let him draw and just counter whatever gas he draws.
Alex is going to play a Temple of Triumph Scry.
Finally hits land 4, yeah.
Yeah, that seems okay, but...
I think Alex is just looking for more lands at this point.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, his hand's just all gas.
Sure.
I see at least one Stoke. Looks like 3 Stokes, actually.
Oh, baby.
So...
Who is that?
That's juicy. That's our new friend.
Yeah.
Narset.
That's a fairly good card.
I mean, so I think we just tick up here. No reason to minus.
We're
nothing
gonna,
really
gonna,
to...
What'd we show...
We're showing an ultimate price.
Okay.
So.
Another card that just great time for a reprint.
Oh, yeah.
Really good. Really good card.
People repping the original Ravnica ultimate prices.
Good. Good for them.
Yeah.
Sweet art on that card.
I like it.
Actually, did FNM have a... Was there an FNM promo ultimate price? I don't remember if there was or not.
I don't think so.
Ultimate price. What am I... No.
I definitely would have
known. There was an FNM go for the throat. I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah. That thing's sweet.
That thing's sweet, too.
Not in this format, though.
Not at all.
No, no go for the throats. Sorry, guys.
So this is going to be a main phase raise the alarm from Alex Preisig. Going to get his 2 soldier tokens. And now in the face of an Narset that can obviously do some damage here.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty hairy if he can't deal with it. Looks like he might shoot it with a Stoke.
I think I'm okay with this play. Barry's tapped down. He has 1 land. You're not really in fear of a counterspell, but he's actually going to Barry's face.
Yeah, go for the face. So Alex is just pure racing at this moment.
Yep.
Just wants Barry's life total to be 0. Doesn't care about Narset.
The interesting thing, I guess, by that line of play, Narset can almost ultimate quicker if Alex is deciding not to do damage to this thing. And if Barry is just continually drawing removal spells or giant creatures, it's going to be that much harder for Alex to deal with it.
Yeah, racing's becoming kind of out the door at this point. But...
No, a banishing light from Alex.
No need
would
to.
Be really impressive.
Yeah, that'd be really nice. He has that option, but I don't think I see one. I think he's still got a few more Stokes at the ready, though.
Yeah.
So we'll see what he's able to do with it. That Silumgar certainly complicates things a little bit.
You gotta like the Pug Dragon. I mean,
I know you like the Pug Dragon.
I like the Pug Dragon. I think he's a solid creature.
I don't know. Something
dealing
about,
with tokens.
Something about non-red dragons just rubs me the wrong
they're
way.
Usually the best dragons.
Yeah.
Saying when you think about the 5-colored legendary dragon cycle from Kamigawa, who's the best?
Yeah,
that's
yeah,
Kakusho.
That's a good point.
That there he is. He's making his debut. But so we got Silumgar. The question is do I like first Pug Face or do I like second Pug Face better? And honestly, I probably like first Pug Face just because he has hexproof, and I'm a sucker for hexproof.
Hmm. See, I'm gonna disagree with you.
Yeah, you like second Pug Face.
I like new Pug Face.
New Pug Face is good.
Not just
he's not screwing around. That card's super strong.
I agree. In this current situation, old Pug Face is a little better. But
ooh, Oh, but that doesn't even get us there,
no,
really.
It's just very unimpressive. It makes a new Goblin Yeti for us.
To look at, but, so you can see your new tokens.
I think that's about the extent it's going to do for us right
now.
Sure. That does make another Stoke live, though, if Alex so chooses to tap out his creatures.
Yeah.
Which, I guess, 4 damage is better than 3, so...
Very true.
I'll take that line. Alex, certainly desperate at this point, though.
So it... I'm assuming he directed that Stoke at Barry, and Barry just chose not to adjust his,
he's
adjust
at 3.
His life. He's at 3 currently, so we're hoping that Alex has the burn in hand.
I think Barry's under the impression he's going to stabilize here.
And he
that he knows he's just dead.
He does...
He's got a full grip and the lands to work with. Kind of... I know he's got an utter end.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like a dig through time. So we'll see how he wants to play this out. I think... At this stage, if you're Barry and you know Alex has another Stoke, I think you just, I think you just pass the turn here.
I agree. I think keeping your mana up as the control player is the right thing to do.
Yeah.
You've already swung in with your,
I mean, so Barry looking like, well, let's see.
Ultimate Price, sure.
Yeah, that works.
Get him off the field. You don't have to deal with that. And then keep the rest of your mana up. There's really no reason to cast anything else. We have an Arset at the ready that we haven't used this turn. So that gives us another peek at the top deck, which we'll, I guess, take right now.
See, I don't know. If I'm Barry...
What is that?
Barry's got a dig through time, and if he minuses that Narset, it's only costing him 3 mana.
To double dig?
It's a lot of dig.
But then he's using 2 blue, has to fetch, and then he's down to 2. So
that's true.
If Alex had, like, Wild Slash Stoke in hand, or land, wild, or land Lightning Strike, Stoke the Flames, Barry is dead.
True.
What does he draw, though?
I think he's got at least a Stoke.
Now, the question is Alex going to look through a dig? Does he have another Treasure Cruise in hand?
Well, I'm seeing Wild Slash, Stoke the Flames. That might be a Roast in between them.
Boy, Roast main board, huh? I don't know if I like that card in the tokens
it's
list.
It's pretty dead.
It's just not, I think, where I want it to be. So we're going to run out a Monastery Mentor here. And this is interesting. Do we have... Man, if we had double Wild Slash... Ugh.
Yeah, that'd be fine.
Disgusting.
I mean, yeah, we've put ourselves off of Stoke now. So, I guess if Barry, like, takes this bait that... Alex doesn't have it. And just decides to go for something big. Mm-hmm. Alex can just surprise him with a Stoke there, but...
No, is Narset ultimate at 9 or 10? I guess that's the question that we have to figure out is what that is at.
Consult our third commentator.
Yeah.
Google.
Definitely check out...
see what he has to say, or is it a she?
I guess either.
What are we calling Google?
We're going to check out the Narset Transcendent Master here. Double check, because if that's at 9, I think Alex kind of... No. Yeah, it is. So your opponent your opponents can't cast non-creature spells.
It's pretty brutal.
That is brutal.
So Alex here... He's struggling with this this play. I think he was debating if he wanted to get a monk off
token?
Of that in response to that ultimate price aimed
sure.
at his mentor. Just going to leave it back. I think he's just, he's going to hit Barry. He's just waiting. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez.
Wow.
Your favorite card.
Oh, baby.
Get counterspelled.
There it is.
For the value.
Cool.
Selumgar's Scorn.
Selumgar's Scorn. I have a dragon. It counts as a counterspell.
Get countered.
We've got Alex down to 13 now after 2 Selumgar attacks. Barry's going to be down to at 3. Okay, so
Barry's
that's
at 3. Yeah.
And Narset is obviously live here. Alex cannot cast non-creature spells.
He cannot.
As Barry has ultimated the Narset.
He must do it main phase, which... At this stage, Barry's leaving up his mana. He's representing counterspell.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's only got 3 life, but this is where control always sits. They let you think you got this, and
oh, but there's a rabble.
Ah, yeah.
Is he dead though?
Oh, jeez.
Yeah,
he is dead. Of course, he's dead. Barry has like 18 cards in his hand.
It's true. Barry has a lot of cards in his hand. Oh, baby.
Here comes Pugface.
And Pugface is just slowly tripping Alex up.
That's what Pugface does.
Jeez.
Like I said, Barry's at 3, but it doesn't really matter. He's got He's got all the stuff.
I mean, with white, you never know. He could have...
As long as it's not zero, he's... Yeah, it's trouble.
There's going to be something else in there.
Now Barry gets to dig. So, yeah, I guess Barry was pretty good to just tick up that Narset.
I think so.
I guess I agree with this line now.
If your opponent isn't burning you... isn't burning your Planeswalker...
Yeah.
If he wants to race it, that's fine. Because, you know, once you ultimate her... All of the rest of the burn in his deck is dead. Yeah. He can no longer cast those cards. So now Alex is relying on a deck that plays maybe tops 8 creatures, 9 creatures, 10 creatures, and it's just not going to get there because half of them are small in the face of Silumgar. So,
yep.
Not to mention, like you said, Barry has been sitting on a pile of removal. I mean, just a...
Oh, yeah. I mean, his hand is just spells.
Right.
I imagine... All of them, if not most of them, just deal with anything Alex wants to do at this stage. So, Pugface going to equalize a little bit.
This is it.
Not quite lethal. Alex on a 2-turn clock, though, and as I said, I don't think 2 turns is enough.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to get there.
I don't think Alex just has the action, especially when Barry's just attacking and leaving up all that mana and just holding all those cards. Alex will go to... Alex
he's at 4 now.
Yeah, so he's going to go to 1.
I think Barry is in the way of discarding.
Yeah, that's never a good sign either.
Not at all.
And just pitches his other Pug Dragon.
Yep.
And getcha.
Game 1. Jeez. So Barry Cohen managing to stabilize against the tokens deck.
Yeah. That's a pretty easy game for Barry there, I'd say.
Yeah, I'd have to agree.
His life total was threatened. But he didn't get to zero. Alex, not with a very fast start. And, control just takes over.
It was interesting to me that Barry didn't, in fact, have a lot of early game removal. No Isle Blights or anything like that. And still managed to kind of pull it out there and wade through some of that early game aggression.
Yeah, absolutely.
Very crazy. All right, well, let's move on to sideboards now. I've got Alex's in my hand, so he's running Jeskai tokens like we saw. He's got 1 Chandra Pyromaster, looks like 3 Valorous Stance, 1 Sirkin Dragon Speaker, 1 Citadel Siege, 1 Twin Bolt, interesting, 1 Erase, 2 Negates, 2 Anger of the Gods, 1 Elspeth, Sun's Champion, 2 Disdainful Strokes, and 1 Glare of Heresy. So what do you like bringing in here?
I'm going to start with the things I'm half and half about.
Sure.
Maybe bring in a glare.
Okay.
It's pretty cheap interaction, these control decks. As you saw, the power of Narset Transcendent put on display there. That's an easy way for Alex to deal with a card he generally doesn't have an easy time dealing with.
Okay.
Some auto includes, I'd say, are his Disdainful Strokes, his Negates.
Yep.
Just match the plan that Barry's trying to do with control here. I also like Elspeth and Sarkin.
Okay.
A little diversity in your threats. If they're not creatures that just die to all of Barry's removal, bring in some Planeswalkers.
Okay.
Just come at him from different ways. Also, Chandra, I think, is very good. Can burn Barry while simultaneously drawing Alex some cards.
So I think we hit on... I agree with 4 out of the 5.
Oh,
I think.
Gee,
well,
here we go.
I'm sorry. I agree with 4 out of the 6.
Okay.
The 1 of Glare is too little for me to bring in against just... The one Narset we saw.
Okay.
Seen some other things like Suspension Fields or any other type of white permanence coming out for Baron, I would think about it. I do like the Negates. Think those are an auto include.
Yep.
Disdainful Stroke, also a card I'm bringing in. Chandra Pyromaster, I agree with you. The 0 in Alex's deck is nuts.
Yeah.
Super good for him. Citadel Siege, snap it off. The card's so good against control decks. If Barry doesn't have the mana up to counter it,
true.
He has no way to deal with that.
Now remind me, that has a mode where he just gain and drains every turn, right?
Citadel Siege, I believe, is... Oh, am I thinking of the wrong one? I am thinking... Citadel Siege is an outpost siege.
Outpost Siege, this is not.
My mind is blown. Okay, hold on a second. Rewind. I may have to rethink about that. Now we're down to... Why do I like... I don't like Citadel Siege, then. Oh, God. Why isn't that Outpost Siege? Why are we playing Citadel Siege?
I think Alex has
main
deck Outpost Siege.
Oh, does he?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Well then scratch the Citadel Siege. Don't bring it in.
Those will stay in.
Yeah
those are fine.
The other 3 I'm fine with. But, so we're okay. You like the Sarkin? I'm not huge on the Sarkhan just because of the amount of heroes downfalls that I assume Barry's running.
That's fair.
Like I said, if Barry was more of like a Sultai control where there were creatures like coursers or something that I was worried about, then maybe the Sarkhan comes in, because then I can either use Sarkhan as removal for a turn before he gets killed.
Mm-hmm.
I just feel like against control, if you're casting them this late from a tokens deck, like, they're probably going to have counter magic up.
I feel like if you're bringing Sarkhan in this sort of matchup, you're just upticking it, though, mm-hmm. and hopefully just getting to ultimate and Form of the Dragon yourself.
And try and draw cards.
Just all the cards. All
right.
I guess if you're more of a control-y Jeskai deck, though, that's not ideal.
Probably not as much, no. So I don't. I guess, that's why I don't know if I bring him in. Wow, Citadel Siege.
He's weird,
Took me for a ride.
Yeah. He got you. He got you good on that one.
Barry Cohen's sideboard, what do we got?
All right, so Barry's rocking one Dragonlord Selimgar, Icefall Regent, one Pearl Lake Ancient, one Dragonlord's Prerogative, two Negate, one Foul Tongue Invocation, two Encase in Ice, four Drown in Sorrow, one Viruent Plague, and one Selimgar's Command.
Interesting.
Lot of one-ofs
Violent
and
plague.
Four Drown in Sorrows.
Four Drown in Sorrows. Yeah. So he's really just going for the... He's going for it all. I like the Drowning Sorrow. Obviously. Like, I think that card is fantastic here.
Do you bring in all four?
Depends on how many Bioblights I have main.
Yeah, he's got Bioblight. He's got the other Silumgar.
Silumgar's Scorn? Is that a card?
Silumgar's Scorn, yeah.
Dang, that's an extra counter spell.
Yeah, it is. Surprisingly good.
Geez, snapping
in this
off.
Match.
I actually like Silumgar's Command, too.
Silumgar's Command, not bad.
Silumgar's Command, pretty
Alex
pretty
has
decent,
a lot of non-creature spells to counter.
He does.
Alex, as I said, might bring in some Planeswalkers to kill.
Yeah.
Some other cards I like would be the Dragonlord's Prerogative.
I think that card's sweet in control decks. I think it's super good.
Especially that Barry... I mean, we saw him that game one. He had a dragon.
Yeah.
He had another dragon in his hand.
Sure.
So I'm led to believe... Also, the Icefall Regent in his sideboard...
Would make you believe that
there
are
additional
dragons.
Leads me to believe he's got a healthy amount of dragons to get value off these cards.
That'd be understandable.
So if Alex is on the mind of, let me out-control you...
Mm-hmm.
No. It's not going to happen.
Not going to work. Not going to counter the Dragonlord's Prerogative. We'll see Alex go down to 19 here. Both players on their first two turns did nothing but trade lands. Alex might have an anticipate at the end of Barry's turn. Very interesting. Dragonlord's Prerogative. I saw that game during the standard win-a-case that Nerd Rage hosted.
Mm-hmm.
Card is pretty good in control decks. Like,
do you like Opportunity?
I do. I do like it.
Do you like it
uncounterable Opportunity.
Yeah.
Seems all right.
I also like it.
At instant speed, thank you.
Sign me up, dude.
So it looks like we'll see...
Get some tokens.
Raise the alarm. So this was a game plan early on that worked before. We might as well try it again. We got our opponent low.
Yeah. I agree. I mean, no real reason for Alex to change his main strategy.
Yeah.
I think if he's bringing in some counter spells, it helps. But,
Tokens are hard for control decks to deal
with. I'd like to see a faster start from Alex. I'd like him to get a turn 3 play, turn 4 play, like an Outpost Siege would be great.
Sure.
We'll see what's in his hand, though.
You'd like to see that Trumpet Blast just come out.
Yeah,
start
I mean, why not?
Rocking people.
Trumpet Blast is a card.
It is.
It was reprinted.
It was. It was made.
You may play it.
And an early Jeskai.
I like Ascendancy, too.
Barry, now, what do you got? You've got an Anticipate after the fetch. So you're dropping down to 17. You're probably going to go find an island here.
I would assume so.
Anticipate. So this is... I actually like this line from Alex, too. An early Jeskai Ascendancy, while Barry does not have mana up to use his... I hate to call it counterspell, but while he doesn't have counterspell mana up, is actually very nice for
just,
Alex.
Yeah, just call it counterspell. It's, you know, these decks, they're just bringing in dragons now. It might as well be.
Sure.
It's kind of. You know what? Even if it's Force Spike,
mm-hmm.
when Alex is tapping out to play an Ascendancy,
yeah.
it still does the work.
Oh, I agree.
That Ascendancy gets countered, so.
Boy, wouldn't... He had no Ashiok in his sideboard, huh? Barry?
Nope.
Interesting.
Not one. Is that a staple of these Esper control decks?
I don't know if it's a staple. It is definitely a card I would consider running, seeing as how so many creature decks are being played right now.
Mm-hmm. It's an option.
And that looks like the Drown in Sorrow, number uno.
Virulent Plague, sir.
Oh, that's the Virulent Plague. Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
Forgive me.
Yeah. If we didn't address that during our sideboard. That's
that is a card you bring
that
in.
That card, I think, you know what? It was automatic. Snap it off. We didn't even have to bring it up.
Sure.
You guys knew. You knew it was supposed to come in.
They understood. Twitch chat's intelligent.
Yeah, Alex needs to get that off the field.
But how? What is our way of removing that? Erase would have been good, but we only had one in our sideboard. A lot of one-ofs. Alex taking the... Yeah. Definitely taking the Saito approach here to sideboard.
I mean, Barry, too. He's got a lot of one-ofs. Like I said, four Drown and Sorrows, sure. The only other thing he's got two ofs are Negates and Encased in Ice.
I mean, that's... I will tell you, from playing in a lot of tournaments, that is the way that a lot of Asian sideboards are set up.
Sure.
Just in general, a lot of the players from Japan, very mathematical about how they're moving cards in and out of the sideboard. A lot of one-ofs. We're mostly for North American players, and definitely in North American tournaments. In some European tournaments, too, you see them go with a lot of three-ofs or a lot of two-four-ofs, even if they consider the card to be super good against a matchup.
Yeah. As a North American myself, I would say I like the more certainty of having multiple copies.
Yeah, you're not deep into the... Though I will have to say, I would agree with Barry on a lot of his one-ofs, because as a control player, I, too, go for that strategy where I like a lot of different one-ofs to kind of mix up my deck and make my opponent play on the defensive.
Sure, absolutely. Yeah, when your deck is set up to draw out the game and take as many turns as needed, you have more chances of actually seeing these one-ofs, so...
So this is
a fine strategy.
Interesting.
Alex playing a creature, which is a start, I guess, to deal with the plague.
Not only that, but Barry still doesn't have a second blue.
That is true.
So Alex is in the clear here to kind of fire off these spells. Alex will gain 4 off of the Stoke the Flames, go up to 23, thanks to the Soulfire Grandmaster.
I'll take that.
It untaps, now a 3-3.
I think it's going to get a little bigger.
We'll see a Lightning Strike again, I believe.
Yep, strike to Barry's face.
Alex now up to 26, thanks to Soulfire. We'll see a loot. Now, Virulent Plague only working on the tokens, correct?
That is correct.
Okay, so this Soulfire is now a 4-4. Coming in for some beats.
Also with lifelink. So we'll just get Alex up to a healthy 30.
Wow, drops. That was a good turn for Alex.
Oh, yeah.
And the fact that Barry's not on double blue here and is playing Spirit of the Dragonhaven, which honestly I think is a mistake. I understand why the card is being played. I do not like it. I do not think that is...
I think it has some implication in certain decks. Maybe not this one.
He looks like he has himself at 29. Is that correct?
That's possible. Maybe he paint. I think he painted himself one.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, so that's fine. Yeah, so Haven. I mean, it does bring back Ugin as well, which Barry might be playing.
Sure.
I'm just
not a fan of it. At this point, I would have rather had a Temple of Deceit or another island or another fetch. I mean, anything here to put me on double blue.
Yeah, arguably better in this juncture.
Now our opponent is able to just kind of have these free turns, and they're not even worried about Counterspell. And that's Rabblemaster.
Rabble Daddy.
He has to pass the turn. The token dies to the Virulent Plague.
As Barry kindly points out. I think Alex knew. We're all pretty hip to the Virulent Plague.
Yeah, that's
we know what it does.
I'm actually not hip to that card. I will tell you, you're hip to that card. I'm hip to Illness in the Ranks. And then I'm 100% honest, and this will make me sound terrible for Twitch app, but I did not read Virulent Plague. I've seen the card probably a bunch, have not read it.
So,
oh, baby.
You are commentating on a card that
who is that?
You have no idea what it does.
What?
That, oh, okay. That is a Dragonlord Ojutai.
And that's a card Andrew plays. Andrew will snap play that card in a second.
Yeah, absolutely.
I believe that guy's what? Is he a 5/6 flying hexproof while he's untapped? When he attacks, you get to anticipate?
I believe you're correct.
Is that what he does?
This is your guy, man.
His power
you
and toughness? Oh, jeez. All I know is that card is a house.
It's going to brick wall pretty much whatever
everything.
Alex does here. Yeah. The door is kind of open, though, so, I mean, Alex might as well start playing stuff.
Oh, I agree.
Triggering ascendancies, buffing his team. Hopefully he finds some action here.
Stacking his triggers correctly.
I mean, he only needs a few burn spells. If he's got them, he wins.
So it's been kind of confusing why this Jeskai tokens list has never tried playing like a Hammer or Purphoros to give their creatures haste. I don't know.
I'm
just thinking, like, it's so... Because you can have these turns where you draw a lot of these cards and it makes so many guys on the field so big, but then you have no way to hastily attack your opponent.
Yeah. I don't know. Hammer always seems kind of awkward to me.
It probably is.
Being a three drop.
In a three color deck, it costs two red. Like,
yeah.
I get it.
I guess it triggers Ascendancy.
Does.
And if you're in a late game and you just want to make some
bodies,
dudes,
it makes bodies.
I guess.
Yeah, I know. It doesn't sound like the best, but like we don't even have like a fervor. We don't have anything to give these. So like if we raise the alarm here and then use the raise the alarm with the Rabblemaster to cast a Stoke, it's like, I don't. But I guess we can't because Virulent Plague is actually keeping us.
Yeah, we have Breakthrough the Line from Fate Reforged.
I like that card.
That gets Goblin Rabblemaster Haste.
It does.
And gets him through the Sojutai.
Yes, it does.
So, I mean, maybe. So also triggers Ascendancy.
Does the Ojutai attack is the question.
Ah, jeez. Barry's pretty low, and... I mean, he's got his double blue now, though, it looks like. Is that card up there? That's slightly hidden?
It was a polluted Delta, but it might just be a blue source.
All right.
Or it could just be a swamp, in all honesty.
I don't know. I think if I'm Barry, I play it safe.
Yeah.
He wants to get a little aggressive, though. You want to get in there. So Alex is going to go from 29 to...
Oh, shoot.
Ojutai's power.
He's got to go to 4. Right, wait, 29. Oh,
yep.
Yes!
You got it.
Yes! Dragon Lord Ojutai. And this is really where it matters right here, is the look at the top three. This built-in anticipate for a control deck is just so good.
Yep.
I mean, I'm not super upset that he doesn't have some sort of Icefall Region ability, which I kind of was suspecting that he would.
Well, that's why Icefall Region has that
ability. I agree.
Yeah.
I understand. I was hoping for a dragon-esque Frost Titan is really what I wanted.
Okay. Yeah, Frost Titan, pretty good.
I like that card.
Yeah, I know.
Mm-hmm. It's another card that...
Well, you like Titans, right?
I do like Titans.
And you like blue cards, right?
It's also true.
Okay.
So Frost Titan definitely fitting both of those categories.
See nothing wrong here.
And that's a crux of Fate.
Oh, what value. My Jesus. God. That is
Stop.
So good.
So if you're Alex, you just don't...
Yeah.
You can't touch it.
It's dead. Yeah.
Yeah, let your Rabble Master
Thanks,
go.
Rabble.
Jeez.
Like, again, Alex still has legs here. He just needs some burn.
Yeah.
I mean, once again, Barry just tapping out.
Yeah.
And
unfortunately, that's a scary way for control to play.
The window's open. Yeah, it's super scary.
Though this plague has...
Alex, I don't think, has the gas, but...
This might be it, though.
Yeah, okay, that'll help.
Mo, dragons. Don't choose cons.
All right, so we're going to...
Ditch the land. You don't need it. Do you need it?
Oh, man.
No, 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 don't ditch that. No! Did he not choose dragons? He chose cons.
He, like I said, he's looking for burn.
If he chose dragons, his raise the alarm becomes a shock to Barry.
Sure.
If he plays a Hordling Outburst, it's 3 damage to him. He turns all of his cards into burn.
No, you're not wrong.
Oh,
I think,
no.
I think Alex has it in his mind that these two cards, Outpost Siege and Jeskai Ascendancy, are going to net him enough cards, but... Not right away, and
is
now Barry gets to untap. So.
Is that not how we play that? Am I crazy? Would no one else do that? Twitch chat.
No, I
help
think...
me out. I mean, that seems ludicrous to me. So there's a Stoke, right? But now our control player has all of his mana untapped.
Yeah. I mean, it's a start, though. Like, if Alex gets to consecutively, like, Outpost Siege a burn spell and then play it,
and
he
then
still triggers Ascendancy.
Spell?
I mean, yeah, it's not bad. But get flat countered. Yeah,
just get completely countered by.
But I'm still getting my Jeskai.
So you still get a card.
It looks like a dragon fodder. I mean, that's.
That would have been 2 damage if we were on dragons.
No, you're not drawing it. I mean, that was 2 cards deep.
Yeah.
Outpost Siege netted him that first card.
The Stoke the Flames. But what did we draw off our Jeskai? Ascendancy.
Ascendancy got us the dragon fodder.
Oh, so did we ditch the dragon fodder?
I'm not. I think he did now, just because he doesn't have a dragon mode Outpost Siege.
Oh, this.
So, I think the best plan for Alex here is to have both an Outpost Siege that's dragons and one that's cons.
Okay.
Obviously, that's not where we are.
Not at all.
I mean, I guess it's kind of like autopilot for a player to just name cons on a board state where there's nothing, like, what? They have no action.
who goes into autopilot mode when your opponent's at six?
I'm just saying, man. Like,
that seems nuts.
He had no creatures. He must have not had, like, very many token generators in hand.
He had to raise the alarm. That's two damage. We put him to four. That means when we draw, Stokey's dead. If he doesn't have counter magic, if we draw Hordling Outburst, do we play Hordling Outburst still in the stack?
I don't think he does.
I actually think he plays Dragon Fodder instead. So yeah, there's a glare. Ooh, glare can target a Jutai though because he's tapped. Ooh.
Still probably gets countered though.
I would agree.
But thank you, Alex, for bringing in Glare of Heresy, because I'd be doing the same thing.
So the one of glare from the sideboard makes a difference.
Gets there. Bye, Jutai. Bye.
Jeez. This is why we never attack with our creatures in a control deck. Always leave them untapped.
Alex getting an ascendancy trigger off that glare, but...
Did he draw something good? Oh! God, this one's good.
Jeez.
Ooh! Spicy!
Barry, don't...
He's going to.
I don't think...
Not good.
I don't think you can
don't
do
reach
that.
For the mana.
No. You're at six.
Okay, he has to choose that he is delving before that spell is countered. He cannot...
Yeah, okay. So, yeah. Just... Yep, it's countered.
Wow. Ouch. Yeah. You tapped.
Nope. Don't. Yeah, okay. So Barry wanting to get back his Ojutai, realizing it's exiled.
Yep.
Just the good old FNM take back.
So that might have just paved the way.
Just kidding.
Just kidding. Not really. Just kidding, but kidding all the same.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, this Outpost Siege on Khans in conjunction with Jeskai Ascendancy is doing a lot of work right now.
Oh, I think it's good. I think we could have killed him already though had we went into dragon's mode.
I don't know.
Really?
We're not netting as many cards.
I don't think it's about netting cards. I think it's about just killing your opponent, right?
But we're digging deeper
sure.
and we're seeing the things that would be good with our siege
you
on
might
a dragon's
not be
mode.
Wrong because Barry keeps tapping out. I mean, yeah. Well, he's got two untapped up here, and once again, I can't quite see.
I think, yeah, I mean,
what he's got
could
up
be
there.
Double blue.
This is an anticipate at the end of Barry's turn, going
into
Alex's
which
turn,
which should resolve. I mean, there's no reason it doesn't. Even though you're at six, if you got a counterspell.
All right, so we see another Jeskai Ascendancy.
That is not bad. Again, like you said, just draw stuff that kills Barry, but
yeah.
Alex is certainly getting a lot of setup here in the late game too,
for sure.
To deal Barry this last points of damage, so it might get him there too.
Yeah. Yep.
Yep. Ascendancy number two.
That is. So that's going to hit the board clear.
So we will get an ascendancy trigger off of that ascendancy, but I don't think Alex went for it. I think he's just opting to not. And just draw three, but he is going to use the ascendancy trigger to loot first.
Before he draws for
and then draw three. Yeah, so, again, he got a token maker, but he can't... Yeah, it doesn't really do... I mean, it's staring down the face of a Silumgar, which they're just going to die.
But once again, we're...
It's, I agree. It's
I think he's...
Not,
I think he, we don't play... I guess we don't play Hordling Outburst, though, so it's not as good in my
it's
mind,
just
is
a,
it?
It's a double-edged sword, man. If you have... If you had this Outpost Siege with dragons,
yes.
You are not seeing that token maker.
A majority of these cards?
As early as you just did now,
sure.
Because it's on cons.
Sure. Understandable.
You can't have the best of both worlds unless he has two of
That's
them.
True. That's very true.
But, I mean, yeah. Oh, I'm not disagreeing with you.
Yeah,
you had some
logic. I wanted to reach for the sun and just grab it. And just smash it on the table.
Sure. Yeah, that would get the job done.
While our opponent's just like, oh, God, this enchantment of my own's going to kill me.
Mm-hmm. Feels good.
Oh, there's always Legacy going on at Nerd Rage. You got a bunch of guys over here playing Legacy. Not tonight, though. Tonight's FNM is standard, but thank you for tuning in. This is only round one, so make sure you guys stick around. If you haven't followed us yet on Twitch, please do.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Yeah, it's always a pleasure to see people having fun and enjoying what we do here.
I enjoy having fun.
Yeah, I do
too.
Yeah,
I mean...
And here we see Narset.
Join us, please. Narset.
Your ugly face.
Mm.
Want to just get riled up.
Yeah, it's... See, the thing is does Barry want to minus it here? I mean, granted, I don't know his hand. But, yeah, no. Thinking about it. Maybe he's just bluffing. He's got some really juicy draw spell in his hand.
Oh, that could be true.
But no, he's just going to plus. probably finds land or dragon on top of his deck, so no draw. But this Narset does present some problems to Alex now.
Very true.
These three enchantments on Alex's side need to start getting him some gas. And that one there is not as impressive.
Yeah, I don't know if Rabble's going to get it done.
I don't think so. It's got a lot of obstacles to overcome if
he
it does.
He does have a Stoke in hand, though.
That is a start. That Stoke... So, yeah, if he's got a Stoke, I think Alex will play Rabble Master. I don't know.
What else is he having? A Dragon Fodder in hand? Is that what that is? Or another
like,
Rabble?
Looks like Stoke, Rabble, a Monastery...
Mentor?
No. Man. My eyes, man.
I know.
Not it's what tough. They used to
it's,
be.
No, it's just tough. The players do a fairly good job of keeping their hands tucked in.
Tight to the chest.
So that'll be a treasure cruise.
All right. I mean, so loot twice. I mean, we just have to start digging. Yeah, so it looks like Alex did play the Rabble, which is now a 4-4. Not going to matter, though, because it does not have haste.
He's drawn
I think
discarded.
I think at this moment it is purely being used as a Stoke Convoker.
Oh, what else did we do? What was
Alex
that?
Alex is just digging so deep.
Was that a... That wasn't a revoke existence, was it? He doesn't have a revoke existence.
Not in his sideboard. I don't believe.
Well, Wednesday night is Legacy Night here at Nerd Rage Gaming. It's Wednesdays at 6:30. You can come in and enjoy some Legacy play. We'll see a draw. No, he's going to scry. Put it to the bottom.
Man, Alex is just doing so much, and it's...
It's not getting anywhere. Yeah, it's kind of floundering.
Looks like a ultimate price is going to kill this Rabble. Alex debating the Stoke. I think at this moment he has given away that he has Stoke in his hand to Barry.
Yeah.
By thinking and touching his land and his Rabble, and I guess you might as well just do it now. Nope. Just going to let Rabble die.
Okay. So.
Gotcha.
Took a bunch of turns, took one card out of your hand, and have not progressed the board.
Yeah. Alex just not finding the stuff.
That's okay.
Unfortunately, I think he wants to find another siege.
Sure.
And like you said, I think name dragons and just start running out these tokens and slowly eating Barry's life total. Also, just making it so Barry has to counter the token generators is pretty good.
But what about that? He doesn't. I don't even think he needs to counter the token generators, does he?
Not anymore. I mean,
between the plague and Silumgar.
Yeah, it's not going to be easy.
Oh, thank you. We got a Bigger Andy there. Follow the channel.
What's up, Bigger Andy?
Thanks, bud. Appreciate the follow.
Welcome to the control domination.
This is the control domination scene right now.
All right, so let's see. What land? Not the best start. But we do get to fetch.
That might be something.
Which might be a start, because Alex is drawing a lot of draw card spells.
Ooh.
And creatures that just die.
What are we looking for?
I think he ripped a dig. So
okay.
I'd cast it.
Yeah, I'd fire it off. I mean, you
Absolutely.
Might as well.
Yeah. I think he has to. I don't think he can wait. So, yeah. Gonna fetch first. Which I agree with.
Mm-hmm.
If the top of your deck has not been kind to you this many times in a row after
you
drawing
might as well fetch.
This many cards, just do it out of principle. I think Alex just like desperately trying to find a few burn spells that are uncounterable.
Sure.
And those don't exist in this format.
Yep.
So
yeah, we don't have the good old counter flux that I'm used
to. Getting dark. Yeah. Yeah. Exactly.
So what does he get? One blue is what we're tapping for. We're cruising again?
That's a cruise for sure.
Yep. Now Alex is at 7, correct? Because he did fetch.
Yes. Okay. He will be at 7. He should be at 7.
So now we'll see Barry tapping some land here. He's going to delve himself. Is this a treasure cruise?
He's digging. He's going to dig.
He's going to dig through time. Yeah. Sure.
cannot cruise in response to another cruise.
That is also true. Sorcery speed, forgive me.
That's all right. You know, you can't know every blue card.
All these blue draw spells are just driving me bananas.
This is like Magic the Draw Cards Gathering. It's just... What is happening? Like, Barry's winning because he has a singleton threat on the field.
Right,
right now,
and that's what I'm saying. I can't imagine. He's got 3 minutes left here, so, like...
He's, like... And he's totally blanking, like, Alex's enchantments.
Yes.
Which is just ridiculous.
Yeah, I agree.
I mean, if I'm staring down this board, I was dead, like, 8 turns ago.
Sure.
I just... it's control.
I don't know. I mean, like I said, I think there's been lines of play here that I totally don't agree with to some degree.
Sure. This game could have definitely played out differently.
Sure.
But again, I think it's the difference between Alex getting Barry down to like 2 instead of 6. I don't know if it really would have made that big of a difference.
So Barry now only with 4 mana available to him.
Yeah.
This is the turn. If Alex is going to do something, he's got to do it here.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Alex, full grip. And if all these cards are just dead...
I feel like he's had gas all game, but like two of Barry's cards automatically blank like his entire team.
Yeah.
It's awful.
Yeah, that plague did a lot of work.
It did.
Just shutting Alex down completely.
Pretty good amount.
Yeah. That might be the game, I think. Like,
really?
When he played the plague. And
sure.
But Alex is a trooper. I mean, he's running this one out, hoping to get there. And at this point, at best, he's hoping for a draw.
Yeah.
Which is never fun.
I mean, it's not the best, but it's definitely better than taking the loss early in round one.
Sure.
I mean, it's 5 rounds tonight, so...
Yeah.
He could always come back. Round one loss isn't, I guess, too bad, but no. I'd want to take the draw, I guess, if I could.
Well,
I'm not stalling for time. You've only got a minute left.
If these are your options, yeah.
Sure.
But... So Alex going to rabble. I think this is the third rabble of this game.
And why do we keep casting the rabble?
It can convoke our stoke, and it might live.
I guess at this point, it's true. If Barry has no removal in his hand...
Yeah.
Which we see a Crux of Fate sitting directly next to his thumb.
I'm just
thinking in my head, like, if he doesn't have removal, then like this Rabble Master might actually do damage.
Again, not going to do 6, though.
I think Alex is at 4 and not at 5. I believe. I don't think he took the ping from the fetch.
Okay. Well, I mean...
I don't.
It's still a 2-turn clock to Silumgar.
Yeah.
So that doesn't really change much.
Correct.
I guess we'll just honor their...
their life
totals.
Whatever
they go with, yeah.
Yep. So there's the Crux. He's going to fire off a Disdainful Stroke.
And then resolve his loot.
Draws is okay.
This rabble growing from the ascendancy buff doesn't matter.
Barry's got a negate.
Yep.
Alex has a negate as well.
I don't know if it's worth it, though.
Really?
I don't know. I mean, I guess. Yeah, there's like
sure.
10 seconds left, sure, but what are you...
Thank you, Holloman dude, for the old follow there. My God, the follower's popping up today.
Appreciate it.
Love it.
Again, welcome to the... domination of control decks.
It's Esper, baby. It's timing around.
Esper's back, man. Alright, so we'll go to turns. Do we often go to turns in the feature?
Sometimes we do, sometimes we don't.
It's just...
It's
a great start to this FNM,
yeah,
let me tell you.
Good
just
start to the FNM.
The full 50 minutes just...
This is everything,
it's
baby.
What I live for.
You wanna watch these decks duke it out.
I mean, just the audience gathering around you as you struggle to draw into this round. It's wonderful. So, Barry coming at Alex. Alex will take what I imagine is his last turn. He does get another one technically, but I don't think it's going to be enough. As he has drawn another land...
Jeez.
This one at least lets him scry, so maybe what he needs is on top.
I mean, we just realized, too, after all of this, had he been on dragons, all of these creatures he's running out, granted if he hasn't seen the cards, as we said, as deep,
mm-hmm.
all of these creatures are still doing damage every time they're removed from the field.
Yeah, I was trying to get a feel for how many Alex has run out since.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it's not 6. it's closer.
So this might be it.
It kind of makes his burn a little more lively. So, yeah, Barry is essentially tapped out. It looks like he's got two up.
Oh, man. But if he pulls this out, I will just be...
For the draw.
I mean, I know. It and it's kind of sad, but still. I mean, if it just gets there, it will be nuts.
Mm-hmm. I don't see another burn spell, though.
Alex, I don't see one either.
Alex
didn't
just
draw one.
Hastily pitching anything that doesn't deal direct damage.
He's got an Anticipate and a Treasure Cruise in hand.
Yeah, I mean, these could find him. So, Alex is saying...
This is how many cards I have.
I think the statistics are good that one of these is a burn spell. Although, of note, he might have taken a majority of them out just because of the matchup.
Yeah.
So I think he's kind of doing the numbers in his head, like, all right, is it even worth looking? He's getting a count of how many Stokes he's fired off.
Oh, boy. I can't imagine.
And it's all just a draw, too.
I know.
So miserable.
It is. It's just sloshing through. To be fair, how do you feel about Narset, though, so far? You like that card?
I mean, it is actually, like, doing work.
Yeah.
It just doesn't seem like it's done much this game.
I mean, game one, when Alex decided to race it...
Yeah.
Blanked his deck. His entire deck. You just made as much as I dislike to say that type of stuff, you made the wrong choice there. Like, you have to at least attack the Narset or burn the Narset. Otherwise, your deck that runs, like we said, 9 or 10 creatures just becomes useless. Like,
yeah.
If the Narset ultimates 2 turns after it comes out, while it's feeding your opponent cards, they're just going to rock you.
Yeah, not ideal.
Not good at all.
So maybe a lesson learned there for Alex.
Probably.
But
And to be fair, that's the first time I think we've had Narset on the stream since she's been released, is in this Esper control list.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, just to be fair, like, it's been upticking.
Yeah.
Which... I agree is the right play for Barry to be making against this
totally,
deck.
Totally, 100%.
I just want to see, like, some bananas prowess spells. You know what I mean? I want Barry to draw, like, 14 cards deep and just reveal all the gas.
Just
you know what I mean? Like
a rebounded dig through time, just
so,
going bananas.
So, like, not seeing the true power of Narset displayed, but, I mean, even still, it's
this
doing
is it.
Work.
Is this... Oh, God, he
Nothing.
Drew 2 land off of it?
He knows.
And now this is the 3 from the cruise. He found the other stone.
He's got it. Just
stoke him.
Draw.
Oh,
maybe he'll be
man.
Good guy, Alex.
Draw and turn stoke you.
Can we draw? Yeah.
Alex says
Barry
that's
says
it.
Sure.
One
yep.
and one. Wow. I can't even believe it. So Barry has what in his hand? Barry's got another Narset, and is that a Silumgar Scorn?
Yeah, so...
But he didn't keep the mana up for Scorn?
Apparently, yeah, he couldn't cast it.
What did we fight over?
We had that one where we were fighting. Baby. We were fighting over a Crux to kill that Rabble.
Okay, so we Cruxed...
Barry
Cruxed.
Alex stroked.
And then Barry,
Barry
negated.
Ugh.
Oh.
Ugh, what is
no,
magic?
Let him have, could he have let him have the Rabble? Let's see. No, he couldn't have because Silumgar was tapped.
Yeah.
And he didn't have removal in hand.
Yeah, that's correct.
Oh, wow.
So I mean, Barry made the plays he had to.